Today's EM in 5 is going to be on the Ottawa Rules. So you say you have a patient that comes to the ER because they've hurt their knee, their ankle, or their foot. We have some decisions to make. How do we decide which patient we're going to x-ray and which patient we're going to give an ACE wrap and send home with instructions to rest, elevate, and ice? Well, lucky for us, there's been some research in this area, and some people in Ottawa have come up with some rules about who to x-ray for knee, ankle, or foot injuries. And the nice thing about these rules is that the assessment can be done just during the normal part of the history and physical. There's nothing special about it. Okay, so let's start off with the rules. To make it easy, I'm going to start off with the first rule, which actually applies to the knee, the ankle, and the foot. And that is, can you walk? So you ask the patient, were they walking either at the scene or in the ER? They're able to bear weight on the foot. If they haven't tried or you haven't seen them walk in the ER yet, you can have them try it out for you right there in the ER in those stylish hospital socks. It is okay if they limp a little. You just needed them to take 4 steps and see if they can bear weight twice on the affected leg. Okay, so for a knee injury, we have a patient, they can't bear weight and they have an age greater than 55. What do we want to add to that? Well, on our physical exam, we specifically are concerned about isolated tenderness to palpation of the patella or tenderness to palpation of the head of the fibula. And also if the patient can't flex to at least 90 degrees, they don't have to go past it, they just have to get to 90. If they meet any of these criteria, guess what? We need to do an x-ray of the knee. So those are the knee rules. All right, next down we have ankle. So again, you've already asked the patient if they've been able to bear weight or not. This is for a patient with pain in the malleolar, the ankle area. On exam for the ankle, we're specifically concerned about posterior tenderness to palpation of the lateral malleolus and the medial malleolus. And remember, this is posterior pain, and it's the distal 6 centimeters. If they do meet those criteria, again, we have to get an x-ray. And there's a summary of the ankle Ottawa rules. Last up is the foot. So again, we know that they have midfoot or foot pain, and they can't bear weight, both on the scene and in the ER. On exam, we're concerned about navicular tenderness to palpation and fifth metatarsal tenderness to palpation, and that's where it correlates on your exam. So make sure you palpate those two areas, because if they have pain there and they can't bear weight in both the ER and on the scene, you're getting an x-ray. And that's the Ottawa foot rules. So how accurate are these rules? Lucky for us, they are fairly accurate. For the ankle, if the rules are negative, the probability of fracture is 0.3%. So make sure to tell your patients that that's the reason you're not getting an x-ray. For children, there's also been studies to show that there were no false negatives. In the knee, the prospective validation shows a 100% sensitivity, meaning just like the ankle, if the rules are negative, the probability of fracture is very low. It's 1% in these studies. So let's review one more time when we're getting an x-ray. Make sure you ask them, can you walk and could you walk on the scene? And for the knee, it's a patient also who's greater than 55 years old. So for the knee on exam, make sure you palpate the patella if it's isolated patellar pain, or if they have pain at the head of the fibula, or if they can't flex the knee less than 90 degrees, you're getting an x-ray. For the ankle, if they have posterior, lateral, or medial malleolar tenderness, you're getting an x-ray. And on the foot, if they have navicular or fifth metatarsal tenderness to palpation, you're getting an x-ray. So you can see they're fairly easy. Make sure you ask the patient a little about the history. Can you walk now? Could you walk then? If they can do neither of those, palpate these 6 spots, and then you'll know if you should or shouldn't get an x-ray. Thanks again for joining us on EM in 5.